Well, despite an apology of kinds, there are growing calls for radio broadcaster Alan Jones to be taken off the air following his offensive remarks about the Prime Minister's late father in an event in Sydney last weekend. According to the News Limited journalist who secretly recorded the comments, not one person walked out of that room in disgust. Jonathan Marshall was the reporter who broke the story and he joins us now live from Canberra. Jonathan, good morning to you. Talk us through exactly what went on in that room when Alan Jones made these remarks.
Well, as you rightly pointed out, no one did leave the room, and that included some of the MPs that were present on the night. I mean, the audio was quite clear. There was an audible surprise. My eyes were trained mainly on Alan, so I wasn't looking around to see what others did. But I think the main point is that these people, some of whom want to lead the country one day, there's ambitions for some of them to be the Prime Minister, remained in the room.
Now, part of Alan Jones's claim or contrition or apology, whichever you like to call it, is that the Chatham House rules applied in this particular event. First of all, what are the Chatham House rules and what was your take? Was there any mention of the Chatham House rules when you were in the event?
So my understanding of the term Chatham House rules is that what's said in the room sort of stays in the room. That phrase was never uttered once throughout the night and in the lead up to it, and by that I mean the email communications between myself and the young Liberal administrators when we were talking about, you know, where do I pay the money, how do I come along, what time does it start, no mention at all, and I went in on the understanding that anything that was said could be reported, and it hadn't been for Alan Jones's comments, you know, it probably wouldn't have been a story. But what he said, we felt, was it weighed significantly in the public interest, and we published, and I don't think anyone today says that was a poor decision.
Was it a closed-door event? Was it supposed to be limited to a particular group, or was it an open-door thing? Did you have to resort to any kind of subterfuge to get in there?
No, none at all. Interestingly enough, it was at a restaurant called The Waterfront in Sydney's Rocks, and there was a wedding taking place on the same floor. So you had some very drunk people who had been at a wedding since about 10 o'clock that morning mingling with the crowd, and some of them actually having photos with Alan Jones. So no one could say this was completely closed off. In terms of those that were there, I mean, sure, and I admit most of them were paid up young Liberal members, but the man who was sitting opposite me at my table, he said he'd never been to an event, was not a member, did not intend to join up, but just happened to be there. So to say it was exclusive is also wrong. And I was able to talk with the Young Libs administration and buy a ticket, come along, and I didn't have to pay up as a member to be able to have that opportunity.
Alan Jones has made an apology, although it did come with many qualifications. What do you think about his apology?
Well, I had the benefit of being at the 2GB headquarters yesterday to watch and listen to that. And I went away after and studied the transcript quite carefully. The word sorry over the 45 minutes doesn't appear once. I guess the only person that would need to judge the merits of the apology would be Prime Minister Gillard, who, in a very dignified way, seems to be remaining quiet on this whole thing.
And refusing to take his phone calls, as we know it. Have you personally heard from Alan Jones?
No, but, I mean, I wouldn't intend to, in the same way that I seem it a bit silly how he thinks that he could just call out Gillard as well. I saw Jones yesterday at the press conference, and someone pointed me out to him, and he sort of left at that point. But he did make reference to the fact that I had attended the event under a different name. Again, another falsehood from Mr. Jones. My name was on the top of all of the emails that I had with the Young Libs. Admittedly, it didn't say I was a journalist, but I don't think anyone else in the room, whether they were a plumber or a school teacher, would have disclosed their occupation either.
Just finally, Alan Jones has made a career out of some very bruising commentary, but in this case, there are calls for him to lose his job completely. You were there, you witnessed the circumstances. Should Alan be taken off air?
I don't think that's a call that I can make. I mean, this is a story about Alan's judgment, and I think his listeners, you know, all 1 million of them, and the advertisers which pay his wages will probably make that decision.
All right, Jonathan, thank you very much for speaking with us this morning. News Limited journalist
Thanks,
Jonathan
mate.
Marshall, who of course broke the story on Alan Jones's comments.